Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men, flower pot men, flower pot men, Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men.
Once upon a time, there was a little house. All round the house was a beautiful garden. And down at the bottom of the garden was a place where the man who worked in the garden left his things while he went into the house to have his dinner. One day, when he'd gone into the house to have his dinner, he left nothing at all behind him because it was so cold that he couldn't do any work out of doors. There was even some snow on the ground and icicles on the shed. But the flower pots were there as usual. Two little ones, two middle-sized ones, and two great big ones. And there were even icicles hanging from the little weed. But she didn't mind at all. When she shook her head, they made the prettiest sound. The little weed looked all about her, and when she saw that everything was quiet, she knocked gently on the big flower pots. But the little flowerpot men didn't want to come out of their warm beds, and they only just popped up and popped down again as fast as they could. Then the little weed knocked again.
Weed! Weed!
What she meant was, come out at once, you lazy little things. It's a bright sunny morning, and everything's sparkling like real diamonds. But still the little flowerpot men didn't want to get up, and they popped out one after the other to say that it was much too cold. And they went on like this for quite a long time. They were just going to put themselves to bed again when they saw old Slowcoach.
Oh, Slug-a-lug.
He walked straight past them, nodding his old head. But he didn't stop. He went right into the shed. Well, thought the two flowerpot men, wherever has he gone?
Oh, where'll he glop?
Oh, where'll he glop?
Then the little weed whispered to them. And what she said was, if you go into the shed, through the hole in the back, you will see something very pretty.
Oh, sorry, very pleep-hop.
Oh, sorry, very pleep-hop. Oh.
So they scrambled out of their flower pots and went into the shed. And they crawled through the hole in the back and came out into the wood. At first, they didn't notice anything different. But when they looked again, they saw that there were icicles hanging from the branches.
Oh.
There were big icicles.
Oh, bleep,
ickle, kickle.
And little icicles.
Bleep, pop, pickle, kickle.
And middle-sized ones. They shone and sparkled in the sun. And while they were looking at them, in came old Slowcoach. He had found a part of the ground which was frozen because there had been a puddle in it. And he just sat on the ice and slid up and down as fast. And before the flowerpot man could see anything, he disappeared. Then Bill and Ben thought they'd try sliding on the ice too. But it wasn't as easy as it looked. And down they fell. Their feet slid away, and their hands slid away, and they fell over every time they tried to stand up. And they got very cold sitting on the ice. But they went on trying, and at last they found out how to slide properly. And they went up and down so well that it really looked as if they were skating. After a time, old Slowcoach came back and wanted to slide some more. So one of the flowerpot men jumped on his back. And away they went as fast as fast. The other one went on sliding. What a big icicle. It was very cold and very slippery. But he thought it would be fun to try and climb right up to the top. And when the other flowerpot man came back, he couldn't think where he'd gone. He'd been playing with icicles too. He'd broken one off and was carrying it in his hand. And he went over to where there were some beautiful icicles hanging and touched them. Then he played a little tune. And he forgot all about the other flowerpot men when suddenly down he came.
What'll you club from?
And look, he was covered with icicles. And the other flowerpot man began to play a tune on his friend. Now, see what happened. The ice began to melt in the warm sunshine, and everything began to drip. Bill and Ben were getting very wet.
Bebop.
So they ran into the shed and wrapped themselves up in two old pieces of sacking that were hanging up there. All this time, the little weed had been waiting, and she knew which of the flower pot men had climbed up the icicle. Now listen, because the little weed is going to ask a question.
Was it Bill or was it Ben climbed the icicle just then? Which of those two flower pot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Do you know? You just listen again.
Was it Bill or was it Ben climbed the icicle just then? Which of those two flowerpot men? Was it Bill or was it Ben?
Was it Bill or was it Ben?
It was Mip.
Yes, it was Bill. It was Bill. They were still wearing their sacks because, although they were quite dry, they liked them so much they wouldn't take them off. But because they were still rather cold, they began to dance about to get warm. Warmer, and they danced all over the garden. They would have gone on playing, but they heard the little weed calling.
Weed! Weed!
She was telling them that the man who worked in the garden had finished his dinner and was coming down the garden path. They went back in such a hurry, one didn't look where he was going, and he jumped into the wrong flower pot. And although they both tried to settle down, there really wasn't room for the two of them. And he had to come out and get into his own flower pot after all.
Oh.
They still had their sacks on, and I expect they tucked themselves up in them to keep warm. They said goodbye to each other. Then they said goodbye to the little weed. The little weed stayed behind the flower pots and went fast asleep. And there they all were, lying quietly in the sunshine. But the man who worked in the garden didn't know that anything had happened at all. Nobody knew about the flower pot men. Only you saw them playing. And the little weed. And I think the little house knew something about it. Don't you?
Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben, flower pot men. Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Ben. Bill and Ben, Bill and Ben.